So hockey was again something very close to my heart, and the cherry on top was, of course, it was a Yash Raj film with Shah Rukh Khan.
Who said I love you first? Did you remember?
I don't. I'm sure he said. I'm very proud that people recognize me as Zaheer Khan's wife. I take that as a compliment. I say sorry first because I'm most of the time I'm wrong. Yeah, of course. I mean, it's not like we meet every day. But when we meet, it's literally like going back in time. Rohit Sharma is the captain. For me, it was Shah Rukh always. And my first shot was where I'm entering, where there's everyone on the other side with Shah Rukh Khan and I'm alone here. So it was just a very... So I think that scene was very natural.
As a business person, it is going all bang bang for you. But now I want to again come to the part that when is Sagarika making a comeback to movies again? A girl from Maharashtra who had big dreams came to Bombay, a national level hockey player, model, actor, and now a business person as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Sagarika Ghatge.
Thank you, Disha. Firstly, the introduction was very vast, but thank you for this. I'm very well. Enjoying everything at the moment. So yeah, very, very good.
Very good. And also, one thing which I want to tell you is, the very first thing is everyone here is waiting for Sagarika's comeback to movies. We'll talk about it. But let's start the conversation from the very start. You're a sports person. Everyone knows it. But talking about your debut, Chak De India. Can we just go back to that memory and refresh that thing for our audience? How does it begin? How did it land it for you?
Oh my God. So to go back in time.
2007.
Yeah, not that long back, but yeah, pretty long back. See, I've been somebody who grew up playing a lot of sports. Wow. Okay. So... I studied in a boarding school and who encouraged a lot of sports there. That's where I took up hockey. I used to be an athlete. I used to do 100, 200, 400. I used to swim. Sports was something I think was my was something I was always very passionate about. But at the same time, because I think these are the perks of being in a boarding school, you end up doing a lot of other things. So that time I used to be very, very inclined, and I used to actually participate a lot when it came to dramatics, dancing. So sports and I think acting was somewhere a parallel field for me while growing up. And I think that is what I feel was, you know, things are written for you, and I think it was written for me to kind of do a film like Chak De. Because I obviously came back to Bombay, and I was in college when, you know, ads and things like that, people used to be like, oh, you have nice skin or this and that. You know, the usual when you're in college,
just starting
used to
off,
come.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
So these were the things that used to come to me, but I was never allowed to do these things.
Oh.
I was like, okay, I'm not going to, you know, this is not, I wanted to study. But obviously, I grew up playing a lot of sports and doing this.
Yeah.
So I think when a film like Chak De came to me, my father really was okay with me doing that, because I think it was a culmination of sports, and he knew my passion was always acting or anything to do with the field of art, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think, so I feel very grateful and very lucky that a film like Chak De came, that I could go ahead and, you know, take it up and do it,
So I feel you manifested it like really well when professional thing is concerned, and even when personal things are concerned.
I think it was
definitely
it was an unknowing manifestation, because I honestly was in HR. I wanted to go to Boston because those were the things at the back of my head also, because I didn't know how to kind of I am not somebody who's from the industry, and you know, I education was important also, so but I think it was an unknowing manifestation that had, that was happening from the very start, I think, in my life. So, yeah.
You were destined, I feel, for everything, which you've come a long way, Sagarika. And also talking about the same Shah Rukh Khan, your debut movie. What was that emotion? I'm very excited to ask you this. What was that emotion when you got to know?
Like I said, for me it was hockey, which was something I played.
Yeah.
I've got selected for nationals from Rajasthan. So hockey was again something very close to my heart, and the cherry on top was, of course, it was a Yash Raj film, it was Shah Rukh Khan. I mean, but yet I was, that time, even then, I was not very sure whether that is what I would be doing. Hmm. It was just there, but it all just kind of, you know, weaved in very nicely, and I think, you know, it kind of, the part came to me. I was one of the last ones to, I think my character was the last character that got locked back then.
Oh my god, the last character, wow. Yeah. Are you still connected with your Chak De girls?
No, of course. I mean, it's not like we meet every day. But when we meet, it's literally like going back in time.
Wow. Yeah?
So because I think we've shared a lot. It is, I think, not only as actors, as people, as, you know, everyone's seen. I mean, it was something too long that we kind of were together for. So everyone knew each other as people more than just as actors, I think.
Any particular actor you're close with from that?
You know, honestly, if I meet everyone, it's literally like, it's that whole riot again.
Oh my
it's
God.
Like, but people who I'm in touch with on pretty regularly are Vidya, are Chitrashi.
Yeah.
These two people I'm very much in touch with. Then there's Arya, there's Shilpa, who, I mean, you know, once in a while you exchange a few messages here and there. So,
but it's good, you know, because of your lives. So people are so busy in their lives, but jab wo mil jaate hai, ya, even a text from them, takes you back to that.
Yeah, I think it's the same thing like what I share with a lot of my friends from school. I probably haven't met them for 10 years, but you know, when we kind of meet, it's literally like going back in time, because again, that's a boarding school, you've grown up with those girls, so it's very different. So I think it's very similar like that with
the bond,
with your first film. And I'm saying it's not only your co-stars, but anybody related to that film, right? You kind of, when you meet, it's that feeling.
It just clicks.
Yeah.
And first is always special.
Always.
Also, any incident from during the shoot, if you remember, if you can share, any incident which has not been known, maybe connected with Shah Rukh Khan, you guys were shooting, any funny incident or something which happened during the shoot? And which you guys,
I think I was only nervous only because my, one incident that I remember very clearly was my scene where I was introduced in the film, right? Because that was the film, that was the scene pretty much that was my first shot.
Yeah.
So imagine my first shot was where I'm entering, where there's everyone on the other side with Shah Rukh Khan and I'm alone here. So it was just a very, so I think that scene was very natural.
Yeah.
But of course in that I had to give a bit of an attitude and things like that. But That scene is my most special memory.
Special memory?
I remember everything. Like, you know, that feeling, what had happened.
Yeah,
you know, everything comes back when you think of it. Now that you're taking me back there. So,
But as I said, first is always special. And it clicks. It clicks the moment somebody's talking to you. As I asked you, kya memories rahi hogi, aisa kuch. Also, we'll talk a bit in Hindi as well. Hindi, English, both. So, now shifting, ek alag sa shift aaya hai aapke life journey, career journey ki baat kare. Pehle to setback, ek reh gaya, ek thehrav aa gaya in terms of acting. But ye to main baad mein puchungi. Now I want to address this one thing. From an actor to a business person now, this shift is very strong. This shift as a woman is very strong. It's very courageous. Now I want you to let our audience know, how did Akuti happen? What it was, what was the planning, what's unique about Akuti? Is it like all Sagarika's mind in it, or is it somebody else's also, you know, what is it? Tell our audience all about Akuti.
Pehle, I will try to, shift is something, yes, that has happened, but it's not that the part of acting is going away anywhere.
Wow.
I think that is something very important to be, you know.
Okay.
That is where my passion lies, and that is always going to be something drives me every day, right?
Wow.
So when people firstly say that thehrav aa gaya hai, I wouldn't like to say that because even when probably there were few things that didn't come out straight after Chak De, but you know, I'd signed a big, big film straight after Chak De, which okay. JP Sir was directing, which we had 2 years lagaye shoot karne ke liye. We shot in some exotic locations. So 2 years udhar chale gaye.
Yeah.
So, वैसे I think I feel like time ne saath nahi diya in terms of it was recession had hit that time.
Yeah.
So you know that such
big
a humongous film at that time hasn't seen the light of the day. Yeah. So that's different. After that, of course, I've done a lot of other work. Yeah. There's Irada. For me, work is about doing different things, for different characters that yeah. drives you as an actor, yeah. right? You have to be satisfied, and it's
Definitely.
About pushing that boundary. We'll come to that later.
Definitely.
But shifting to Akuti, Akuti was born unknowingly, I think, since for me as a child.
Wow.
Because Akuti is an ode to all the women of my family who have grown up. Aaj, I think, jis tarah se main, you know, I dress up, the way I carry myself, it's all because maine apne my grandmother, my Ajji, my, you know, my kakis, I've seen them dress up a certain way, my mother being my biggest inspiration.
Wow.
So Akuti was born unknowingly from there because I always realized ki, even when I was in Bollywood, I would never want to follow trends. Like, you know, there were a lot of things that
are
trending.
You want to create your own trend.
No, I don't want to create my own trend. I want to be real to the person I am.
Okay.
I have grown up in a way. I've seen aesthetics in certain way. I just believe in those aesthetics and I like to keep it like that. And I would like to wear those clothes. So whoever likes to wear those kind of clothes will wear these clothes.
Definitely.
So for me, that is important. It is, Akuti is a brand and of course, The main speciality, you would say, of Akuti is that it's a hand-painted brand.
Wow.
So the hand-painting has come from my mother. My mother has been painting for a very, very long time, since I think since she was 15 or 16 years old. And she used to paint on fabrics. So what happened was, I think Akuti as a brand is an ode, is like a gift from a daughter to a mother. And I think my husband plays a very important role here because he's the one who's pushed me and my mom to do this.
Wow.
Right? So, and she used to paint also as, since I think after I was born, my brother was born. I don't know if everybody knows, but I think most people do know I come from Kolhapur. So we have this house, we have a really nice garden. My mom was always very fond of gardening. So, you know, a lot of the time, a lot of flowers that she used to see in the garden, because she used to be so involved in the gardens, were the flowers that were painted on her sari.
Wow.
So today, though, I think the crux of the brand or the where the inspiration comes from is she has painted so much over the years. Like today, what I'm wearing is again Akuti, and you see these flowers which are painted. But it's literally not something we are, of course, creating a lot more, and as we go forward, we will create. But our first few collections were so easy to make because everything was literally there for us. Like it was like a trunk that you had to just open and
it.
You had to kind of recreate these things, right? Where it came to painting.
Yeah.
And of course, when going back, anything that was old, which, you know, my great grandmother, there were these chanderis, which were hand woven, which were in real zari. Yeah. So I just wanted to, like, you know, recreate those in some way or the other. And that's what I've tried to do with Akuti.
Definitely. And I feel it's clearly visible. I was about to ask you that the thing which you are wearing is very unique, very unique. And it is from Akuti. Let me tell you, guys, it's a different brand. It's, I feel, minimalistic at the same time, very simple, sober. You guys can always go and check out it's Sagarika's brand, and I feel after this interview many people will like what you're wearing. It's something out of the box, I think.
So this is something obviously very different that we've created. Like, I am somebody, yes, I love my Indian, I love saris. You'll see me a lot of the time wearing saris and salwar suits, but I'm somebody who even likes to obviously wear, you know, your western wear. And for me, again, what appeals to me is so what we've tried to do is try to create a Western line so that, you know, there are a lot of people who like to wear something that's different, but probably they would not want to wear saris every day. And even me, it's not that I wear a sari every day, right? So I think that's what we've tried to create, and you know,
with your brand.
But yet keeping the aesthetics the same.
The authenticity. Still lies.
Yeah,
it's your baby, I feel.
Akuti is
Sagrika's baby, and I feel Zaheer played an important role.
Of course.
Was it his idea? Was it yours? You said that he pushed you for the same.
See, the idea is all, like I said, it's a brand unknowingly has been there with me and my mom since I was a child. Because, you know, even during that time when, you know, you could go and buy clothes, my mom would always create a lot of clothes. And me and her would sit together and make them, right? Whether it was the old saris that were taken out. And, you know, we used to always kind of try to preserve as much as we could.
Yeah.
There were a lot of saris which were passed down from my great-great-grandmother, which were like real zari saris, right? Which had zari weaved into them.
Is it existing right now?
Yeah. So
Do you know it?
Yeah. So a lot of Akuti's now collection, the borders that we've made, we've taken like inspiration from them. So I still remember as a child also, we used to, you know, like remove it and keep it so that it doesn't get
tarnished or something.
Yeah, and or you would try to put it on a different sari
suit.
So these things were always happening. I still remember my farewell sari in school.
Yeah.
Two farewells, the house farewell and this. Both saris were painted by my mother. There was a blue and a pink sari again with flowers. And I'm talking about 2003.
My God. You still have it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like I said, it's a trunk. We are just removing things and trying to make them again to, you know, and give them out.
For the people, for the people who like something, you know, to try something out of the box, I feel Akuti is the ideal thing.
I think people who like minimalistic yet some elegant stuff, which is not heavily embellished, I guess, because here your embellishment is in the art, is because there's a lot of work that goes in painting. You know, it's at the end of the day, it's all done by hand.
Yeah.
So it's like a painting on your garment. Yeah, that's
definitely
what it is.
So Sagrika, moving on, as a business person, it is going all bang bang for you. But now I want to again come to the part that when is Sagrika making a comeback to movies again? We all want, I'll tell you one thing, whenever I look at your Instagram post or everything, there's always a comment of people asking, when is Sagrika, when are we going to see her back in movies? Do you have any plan? Do you have any other sort of plan apart from movies, maybe into a production house or something? What is it on your platter?
I think I'm somebody who loves art.
Yes.
So it can be any form of art. That's why I think with even when it anything that, you know, puts your energy out in creating something, I think that is where my passion lies as a person. So that's why with Akuti, it's again special because it is creativity at the end of the day. Acting is, I'm so passionate about that, you know, I always would prefer to be on set than anywhere else. And anything that helps you create that is something I am doing at the moment. Yeah. So I think even though COVID took a little bit of a setback, I have been working on a few things. I have taken the rights of an Argentinian novel.
Wow.
And we have done the screenplay of that. So that is going on. Then there is some sports content we are also creating as something that I have done a little bit of work on. So that is going on.
This is interesting.
So there's a lot going on at the moment. And come back, I wouldn't say, I don't think I went away anywhere.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Because I did do a couple of films, which again was something that I believed in. So whether it was a film like Irada that came out with Nasir Saab and Arshad.
Yeah.
Again, for me, what matters is the character that I'm portraying and the people I'm working with and what I can learn from them. So for me, that has always been the most important thing when I take up anything. So I got to learn a lot. It was a film that was dealing with a very sensitive subject. So that is something, again, I connected with. So as long as things challenge me to do something, is, you know, as creatively, that's what I'm open to.
That pulls you.
And I've never had any barrier about languages. I've done a Marathi film called Premachi Goshta, which was very well received I worked with one of the greatest actors. I consider him as one of the greatest actors, Atul Kulkarni. Yes. Again, learned a lot from him.
Yeah.
I've done a Punjabi film where I played a very different character, where I'm somebody who people look at being very modern.
Yeah.
It's a opposite to what
Proper,
I am.
Yeah.
So as an actor, as long as I get to do something different, mm-hmm. for me, that gets me out of my comfort zone in such a way that, you know, where when I come back and I'm like, okay, you know, mm-hmm. I have that little bit of a thing that tomorrow I have to do this scene. So I like that little nervousness. I feel okay. when I get that little nervousness makes me do something,
drive more.
And I think that's what matters, I think, for any creative person, you know, who's in the industry. So I think, like I said, I don't think I've ever gone away. Yes, I've just prioritized things in such a way that everything has its time. So I feel like I got married. For me, it was important to give time to my relationship, to this, to, you know, everything. I like to travel. So as long as I'm doing my own things and I'm coming back and again putting myself in a scenario where I'm working, yeah. where I'm channeling my energy in such a way that, so even if I've probably not come on screen right now, I have still been working on things. So it's not that I've not, I've not been out of it.
Yeah, things are in the process, yeah. I feel, and yeah. the outcome will be with a bang, I feel.
Yeah, also I think it's more about, I think I've probably never, yeah, you're right. I've probably never gone to anybody saying, give me work. Never done that.
Yeah.
So I guess sometimes, you know, some of your work needs to come out for people to understand what kind of work you do. And I think,
Anything lined up, any special thing lined up when movies are concerned, if you can share?
Like I said, there's all this going on. So I'm hoping that, you know, something comes out soon. That things can progress.
Sagarika, as a producer, are we going to? Is it like something on paper?
Creatively, I've been working on this. It's not easy to go get the rights and develop them. It was a this thing, but I believed in the subject, I believed in the story,
mm-hmm.
and that's why I've gone ahead and got the rights of that.
So Sagarika, as a woman, especially when you are a cricketer's wife, aapko us nazariye se zyada dekha jata hai. Your work has always been neglected. No matter how much do you give it to the industry, no matter, you know, you have started your business venture as well. But at the end, when it's there in the society that you are being known as, you know, Zaheer Khan's wife. And when the trolling is concerned, people trolls you for, you know, reasons which are not even valid, to be honest. How do you address it, if you want to address it to all the people out there, commenting that you're Zaheer Khan's wife? But let me tell you guys, let me take a moment and tell everyone that Zaheer Khan's wife, Sagarika Ghatke, that's a proud thing which I feel.
That's what I was saying. I'm very proud that people recognize me as Zaheer Khan's wife. I take that as a compliment today.
It comes with trolling. I've seen it. People trolls you for that. But do you feel kabhi aapko aisa laga that you have been neglected? Your work has been neglected. Have you ever been affected by that?
Not at all. Like I said, for me, I just said that, you know, for me it is important. Things are given priority, right? When you're doing something, you give priority. When you are in a relationship or when you get married, that's your priority. Yeah. So for me, I am Zaheer Khan's wife, and I'm very proud to be Zaheer Khan's wife. So I mean, I more than anything, I feel very honored.
Yeah,
that
true.
You know, I'm his wife.
It's represented in India so well, and definitely. But talking about the other aspect of trolling, also, you know, I'll say just Anushka Sharma also gets trolled because Virat doesn't perform well or anything. But here, I wanted to ask from you that when you guys decided that you now want to take your relationship next to marriage, kya discussion rahi thi? What were the bouncers? How did you guys defended yourself? Kya discussion hua tha? Was it smooth?
It was actually not very difficult because I think we both as people are very very similar that way, you know, like generally with everything, whether it is being out there, even when it comes to personally, we are quite, we are very home oriented.
Wow.
We are not, you don't really see us much out all the time. Yeah. Only when it's necessary we are out. So as people, we are very similar. So when it came to marriage, it was a very, it was actually quite smooth. And, you know, families were very supportive. And I think Zaheer as a person is so mature and, you know, he's so balanced that even if I'm going off balance, he kind of gets me in the balanced position. So I think, so not at all.
Always been a support system.
Very, very.
Throughout your journey.
Throughout.
So talk us through your love journey as well. If you can just tell, how did you guys met first? What was that?
We met through common friends and... like I said, it's nothing. We met through common friends and we started obviously spending a lot of time together and and the things progressed.
And then eventually you guys clicked and everything. Yeah. Who said I love you first? Did you remember?
I'm sure he said. I don't think I said it.
Not expressive as a person. Who's more expressive, Zaheer or you?
Zaheer?
All the time?
He's expressive.
Wow. That is what I feel women also likes. It's opposite generally. Usually jo hota hai wo nahi utna express kar pate.
No, I'm expressive, but Zaheer is very clear. So I think that's a good thing. I can get a bit confusing sometimes.
Yeah, and also I always, you know, this is coming from my like personal thing. I always have admired women who wear their loves on their sleeves.
Yeah.
So courageous and, you know, so beautiful that thing is. You've never shied away to accept the fact that, you know, you guys were dating or something. Ha, starting I feel that you guys...
No, I don't think it was shying away. I think as people, like I said, we are not very... So we were not trying to hide anything, nor were we trying to tell anything to anybody. So I think it was just when it came out, when people realized it, it came out and we were like, yeah.
Yeah, we are
so
together.
It was a very simple thing. I don't think there was any, you know, trying to play any
any gimmick or something.
No, I mean, not only gimmick. You know, some people like to keep it very private. Yeah. We are private as people, but it's not that we were trying to make an effort to keep it private. Or when it came out, we were trying to make an effort for people to know
together. So I wanted to know from you. As you said that Zaheer is always clear when it comes to expressing things, and also that you guys were not bothered about what's happening outside. You guys were very normal, even when it was out, even when it was not out. Also, I remember Virat Kohli went up to Zaheer Khan when Anushka and Virat were dating at that point of time, and he went up to him for the advice that media bahut, you know, peeche pad rahi thi, and Zaheer told up a straight thing that there's nothing to shy away.
Zaheer told Virat that
there's nothing to shy about it. If you are in a relationship, own it. And I feel he's always been a clear person.
Always. So that's what I'm saying, right? He's always been a very clear, no nonsense kind of a person when he kind of says something. And I think that's what not only me, I think a lot of people even in the cricket fraternity look up to him for that. And I think a lot of people also take his advice on that. So I think, generally, like, you know, when it comes to any kind of advice, maybe cricket or personal, I think Zaheer is very clear with the way his thoughts are. And I think maybe because of that.
Virat went up to him. And also, I remember your first appearance together. Not as a couple, but you guys were in a relationship. It was at UB Pa's wedding. And the same happened with Virat and Anushka. They came to your engagement party. They were not together. So I just connected the dots and I was like, oh my God.
maybe, yeah.
Yeah, that was the thing. So now, Sagarika, we'll move on to the segments. A very playful segments. So the hashtag show with Sagarika. So you need to give hashtags to the following people.
Oh my God, I'm very bad with all these things.
I hope your hashtag game is really good.
I am very bad with hashtags. I'm very bad with social media. I try to do my best with whatever little I do on my Instagram. But please excuse my if I fail in this.
No, you will not at all fail. I feel you will pass this. Hashtag to Zaheer.
Humble.
Shah Rukh Khan.
Greatest.
Imran.
Hashmi? Very friendly.
Vidya?
First co-star.
Wow. Deepika?
Elegant.
Alia.
Great actor.
Ranveer.
The most amount of energy. He's the best.
I
love him. I think Ranveer is somebody, he's great.
Great as an actor.
Great as a person. The amount of energy he exudes. Whenever I meet him, he's lovely.
Is he all over the place?
No, I think he's just lovely. He just kind of changes those 10 minutes around you. And I think it's a great quality to have. Not everybody can do that.
Plus, it's not just that he's doing it for that moment. I feel he's that person by himself only. It's everyday thing for him.
What I'm saying. It's great. Like, you know, those 5 minutes, he changes it. It's amazing.
Ranveer.
Humble again?
Humble again. Virat? Hashtag to Virat.
He's King Kohli, right?
I like it. I like it when Sagarika goes to that cricket element, definitely. Anushka?
The most down to earth, like very authentic as a person.
Authentic as a person. Salman Khan?
I think a lot of people's first crush.
Was it yours?
For me, it was Shah Rukh always.
Always. Kareena?
I think the best today. Nobody can... I think no one has come anywhere close to her.
Madhuri ji.
Again, the most... best dancer.
Best dancer?
Yeah.
Athiya?
Lovely.
Lovely for her. She radiates, I feel, sunshine.
Athiya, lovely energy. I love her. I love Athiya.
You love her. Tripti.
I think she's the new sensation or the new crush. That's what I've been hearing.
Priyanka?
Great vibe.
Sania.
Sania Mirza?
Yeah, Sania Mirza.
The greatest tennis player, and she's a friend, so yeah,
definitely. Next is the rapid fire round. You need to be very quick with the answers.
Like
you
cannot
you cannot take so much of time. So rapid fire round with Sagarika. I hope your answers are quick. One actor you would love to work with?
Ranveer Singh.
Alia or Deepika, according to you, is a better actor?
I love Deepika.
Deepika. Apart from you, who's your favorite Chakde girl?
Apart from me, I don't have favorites. I love them all.
All? Yeah. No, nobody from even...
Chitrashi, because I think all my scenes were with her.
Yeah.
When we meet, I just feel like we go back in time.
What is that one thing which you love about Zaheer?
Like I said, he is so humble. He's so down to earth after achieving so much. And it's very rare to find that in people. And I'm so glad that I find that in my husband.
One thing which you not hated but you know get irritated by one of his
he is punctual but not very punctual, like he can be he knows he'll get there on time, but the person who's coming with him will always feel he's late, so because of which, and I'm somebody who's that extra cautious person who wants to be there on time, so I'll be there 10 minutes early but he'll be there on time. But that makes me very angsty. So I think that is one. We always have fights about this, going to the airport, to everything. We are always... But he somehow manages to reach on time. I don't know how he does that, but I think...
He has a clarity, I feel.
Like I said, he's like, I told you. And when sometimes by chance, we'll go 10 minutes early and he's like, I told you this is going to happen.
Any pickup line? Maybe kuch aisa ek line bol diya ho kabhi Zaheer ne aapko while you were in a relationship, it stuck with you. A very sweet, cute line or something.
No, I really don't know. I don't think he said anything cute. I think he's a man of few words. He doesn't talk a lot. But what he talks is...
Any wise words? So, wise words, bata do, if he would have said something.
I really don't know. I don't know. No.
One thing which comes to your mind when I say the following. Power couple.
Deepika Ranveer?
3 a.m. friend.
3 a.m. friend, not from the industry. I have my friends who I've grown up with. Rishi, Ritik and Ritika.
Shah Rukh Khan?
Shah Rukh Sir.
Imran?
Like I said, I had the best time working with him.
Best actor?
Shah Rukh Khan.
Again?
I said I'm a Shah Rukh Khan fan.
Best actress?
Kareena Kapoor.
Chak De India?
Who I am today as an actor?
Zaheer.
Life.
Wow. If you were to give a title to the following biopics of people, of the sports person, what would it be? Thoda sochna padega.
Okay.
But theek hai. First is Virat.
King Kohli, right?
King Kohli, the biopic.
I mean, that's something you can't... I mean, that is...
It
just defines him, right?
For Zaheer, if the biopic were to be made...
Zach is back.
That's
been his tagline for the longest.
For the longest. Sania Mirza?
The force of India.
Wow.
Like what she's achieved today is something that you can't take away from her.
Nobody. Rohit Sharma?
Rohit Sharma is the captain.
Will always be the captain for everyone.
Yeah.
Kapil Dev?
Again, one of the greatest cricketers. So what can you... I'm nobody to kind of give them a tagline. Yeah. It's like, you know, it's a little...
Mary Kom.
Fighter. Powerful.
Sania Nehwal. Lastly. The pride of...
Girl power
suits. Now, the last segment is what the comments. We've been through the comments of your Instagram profile and we've thoda sa nikala hai. So, just your opinion, your one word on it. So, kisi ne likha hai that perfect example of love and humanity who respects all religion. I've seen you recently, you guys celebrated Gudi Padwa and Eid together in the most special way. So, ye kisi ne likha hai that perfect example of love and humanity who respects all religion. What do you have to say on that? People troll you even for that. We'll not go into the depth of,
I think,
you know, religion,
like,
but what do you have to say?
Said, it is something very personal that is a part of me, is a part of Zaheer as people that we are, who are very, it's something that is a part of our everyday life. So there's nothing I can comment on that because that's who we are.
That's who they are. Madam is so beautiful in this world. You must have got so much of compliment around your beauty.
No, I mean, thanks to my mom and my dad and my... But at the end of the day, I feel beauty is all that is within you.
Yeah.
And if that kind of... If you're clean and if you're true from within, I think it's always outshines the beauty that's outside.
Definitely. Where did Sagrika disappear suddenly?
Firstly, I hope I can tell people that I'm very much here, very much going to come back, do some great work, and I really appreciate all the love that people kind of give me, because every time I do post, they only ask about me, you know, when am I seeing you on screen, so...
Hopefully soon,
yes.
जब ये लड़ते होंगे तो sorry पहले कौन बोलता होगा? You and Zaheer.
Me. I say sorry first. Because most of the time I'm wrong. I'm telling you, that is also the fact.
Are you like that impulsive child with Zaheer?
Yeah, no, because I know I'm wrong. Okay. And that time also I know I'm wrong, but I'll still say whatever it is. And then I will know that I was wrong. So I always... And he also knows that. So he also ignores it most of the time. So it doesn't matter.
Sagrika, your brand Akuti is luxurious or even common people can, you know, have access to it. What is it? If you can just tell our audience.
It really depends on what you call luxury, A. For you, if luxury is something that can be passed down, through generations, according to me, that is luxury.
Yeah.
It's not about how much it costs or how much... work is there, how heavy it is. Luxury is about how can you preserve something or how it can be passed down through generations. And Akuti is about that. So if this is what you think luxury is, then yes, Akuti is luxury. It's quiet luxury.
Yeah.
Whether it's for the common people, well, it is for everyone because we have come up with... we have given importance to what we are using. For us, it's all about hand woven, handcrafted. So
painted.
So these things, I mean, I'm not saying painting for that matter, you can't kind of put a cost to painting.
Yeah.
But we are obviously trying to
balance
do things where everyone can have a part of it.
Yeah.
And and I hope people, I mean, the response has been great so far. So I just hope that, you know, people give more and more love to it.
It will grow and it will scale up, definitely. Admiring you as Preeti Sabharwal and can't wait to see you back.
Thank you.
I'm telling you, people are, you know, desperately waiting, you know, for you to make a comeback now. What does she likes the most, cricket or hockey?
I have been a hockey player. Mm. I've grown up playing hockey. I've been not only a hockey player, I used to be an athlete as well.
Yeah.
But I have grown up watching cricket.
Yeah.
So, and today, invariably, I mean, I end up being surrounded with a lot of cricket talks. So, I think I'm an Indian at the end of the day. So, cricket is something we enjoy. Hockey is something, is my passion, and I will always continue. Like, to, I know I can pick up a hockey stick and start playing, right? Because I have played that all my life.
You have it
so
in you.
I mean, it's something like what has made me who I am today. Sports also is something that has made me what I am today.
Yeah.
And in that aspect, hockey is what has made me today.
Yeah. And talking about cricket as well, IPL, Chennai, your favorite IPL team?
Favorite?
Has to be, I feel.
Favorite IPL team right now, I think I'm looking forward to the World Cup.
Oh my God.
That is what everyone's looking forward to, for, I think.
For the World Cup. Yeah, but still your favorite.
Right now I'm only cheering for Team India.
India! Thank you so much, Sagarika. It was lovely talking to you, having a chat about your life, about your career, about your business perspective. What exactly is your perspective? And I feel you're very clear with your brand. What exactly do you want to portray it out and you want to give it out to the people? And anything you want to just, you know, sum up for our audience?
No, it's been great. I think it's been great chatting with you. Thank you for having me.
Yeah.
And you took me back to a lot of things which I had kind of, forgotten about.
Yeah.
But yes, it's always fun to
always
have
fun.
A chat.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.